Okay, let's talk about Mayon volcano now. The rockfall events, is there a frequency increase in these incidents as you've noted?
So yesterday was the peak of rockfall events mm-hmm. in Mayon volcano. We recorded 74 rockfall events. This is from 5 a.m. the previous day to 5 a.m. Of the reporting day. No? And today we recorded 46 rockfall events. Now, the significance of rockfall is that rockfall is generated by the collapses on the sides of the lava dome that is on top of the volcano and essentially plugging the conduit of the volcano. So if it's collapsing, that means that something is pushing, trying to push out, you know, or is pushing up beneath the dome. And that means that lava is trying to get out. So that tells us that this activity can progress in two ways. There are two scenarios that we are looking at. The first is the 2018 scenario in which frequent rockfall has actually progressed into a significant magmatic eruption that would be followed by effusion of lava flows, lava fountaining events, explosion events, and even explosive events that can produce tall eruption columns.
Okay.
But the most likely scenario that we are looking at, because of the other parameters that are present, we have low SO2, minimal ground deformation, concentrated only at the top, at the upper slopes of the volcano. So we are looking at a 2014 scenario, possibly. This is the more likely scenario as of today.
Okay.
In which we can have this kind of activity, rockfall, and maybe a short lava flow. But this will cease after a few months.
Okay. Maybe. Now, when Marton, let's go back to what you mentioned earlier. You said the rockfall event has peaked yesterday from 74. It is now down to 46. Is that a sign that, you know, the activity is easing?
We cannot judge just by two, from just two data points.
Two
we
days.
Need to look at the longer term behavior.
So it's also possible that, you know, you have extreme rockfall one day, it decreases the following day and then increases again.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, it's possible.
Okay, let's talk about Canlaon now. What is the status there right now in Negros Occidental, particularly in the Canlaon area where some activities also been noted by FIVOX?
Okay, so Canlaon volcano has been at alert level 1 for a few years now. No? So we have been recording a lot of low-frequency volcanic earthquakes from the edifice. The low-frequency volcanic earthquakes are associated mainly with the movement of gas, volcanic gas. And most of these earthquakes are very shallow. No? They are near the surface of the volcano. So that tells us that the hydrothermal system or the heated steam region beneath the volcano is actually very active.
Okay.
And this means that there is an increased chance of a sudden phreatic or steam-driven eruption from the vent of Canlaon volcano.
Okay, Mariton, you said this has been going on for years. You mentioned a while ago it's been going on. What makes the situation different from the previous events?
Okay, we recorded a relatively high sulfur dioxide emission from Canlaon on June 5. Everything had to happen on June 5. So the emission was 1,089 tons per day. This is quite high for Canlaon because the base level or the baseline of SO2 emission is somewhere between 200 to 300 tons per day from the summit.
Okay, now the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines has already issued an advice to pilots to avoid all three volcanoes today. What can you tell us about this safety precaution? Is this something that we usually do when the situation is worsening?
This is something that we have to do all the time for our active volcanoes, and most especially our six most active volcanoes, because there are types of eruptions that do not have any warning or any precursory parameters preceding them. So this type of eruption, yung phreatic eruption, the steam-driven eruptions, can happen even at alert level zero.
Okay.
And most especially if the volcano is at alert level, is at heightened alert level. So this is something that the CAAP should impose not only now, but also all the time.
Okay, lastly, what is the advice to residents, specifically those living near the three volcanoes, Taal first?
Okay, for Taal volcano, we would like to remind our fellow Batangueños to please, you know that you have to avoid Taal volcano island, but also for our communities around Taal Lake to keep safe from volcanic smog or fog.
Okay.
Stay indoors, close windows and doors, and use a mask or a wet cloth to safeguard against excessive sulfur dioxide, especially if you can smell this. And if you need help or medical assistance, please do not hesitate to contact your local government officials, and they will help you. Now, for residents of Mayon, Albay province around Mayon volcano, please be reminded, we already know this, no? That you should stay away from the permanent danger zone. This is a 6-kilometer radius area from the crater of the volcano. Because of the danger of a sudden explosion, a steam-driven eruption, maybe large rock falls and landslides and possible uson or the pyroclastic density currents if activity suddenly escalates.
Uh-huh.
For residents outside of the permanent danger zone, we need to get ready for evacuation just in case the volcano's activity escalate.
And what about Mayon? Canlaon.
And for residents of Negros Occidental and Negros Oriental around Canlaon volcano, please, we should always review our preparedness. For the local government units, especially the Canlaon Volcano National Park Management, we should avoid or stop the hiking activities around the 4-kilometer permanent danger zone. It's a popular hiking area, so we should stay away from these areas. And if there are observations that our communities around these three volcanoes are experiencing, please do not hesitate to contact FIVOX because your information can help us.
All right. Lastly, Mariton, what are the chances that you're increasing alert levels in the three volcanoes, at least for Taal, maybe even to start with?
For Taal right now, we are not seeing any other outstanding parameters. The volcanic tremor that we have started recording last June 2, which is still ongoing, has more or less been decreasing already in strength.
Okay.
We have not recorded any other parameters. If there are other parameters that worsen for these three volcanoes, then we will consider stepping up the alert levels.
So it's the same for Mayon and Canlaon. They stay at alert levels. Mayon is alert level 2 or 1?
Mayon is at alert level 2.
And Canlaon is alert level
1. Alert level 1.
And it stays that way for now. Thank you so much for the insights and the information, Mariton Bornas, Chief Volcano Monitoring and Eruption Prediction Division of FIVOX. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Stay safe, everyone.
Stay safe.